arsenals of the steelmakers, the heart of industrial America, providing the United Nations with the tools of war. Here in the giant furnaces of Chicago, of Detroit, Cleveland, Buffalo, Pittsburgh, America is producing more steel than the rest of the world combined. Now geared solely for the production of steel for war, the mills are rolling 24 hours a day, 7 days every week. In endless streams, the hot molten lava flows to the forge of Mars. Out on the Great Lakes and to the mountain ranges beyond, mammoth carriers race to keep up with the mill's demand for iron ore. Here, in the largest open pit iron mine in the world, the battle of transportation begins. Digging a man-made canyon a mile wide and 2.5 miles long, with electric shovels weighing 750,000 pounds. Shovels that take 16 tons of ore in each scoop, loading a 50-ton railway car in 3 mighty bites. Day and night, 85 car trains roll down to the ore docks, each train carrying 8.5 million pounds of iron ore in every load. Below the massive trestle, ore bins yawning wide, the lake freighters await their cargoes. The big chutes open and down it pours. Record loading time, 13,000 tons in 16 minutes. Enough ore in a single cargo to build 6 modern destroyers. Out into the broad waters of Lake Superior, the carriers begin to move. A bridge of ships 1,000 miles long, 20,000 passages a year, racing against time and the weather. The race begins with the first cold days of the northern spring. For in 8 months, the freighters must haul enough ore to keep the steel mills working through the entire year. Through the peril of fog and snow and ice, across 90,000 square miles of landlocked water, the Great Lakes fleet is winning the battle of transportation. Iron ships and iron men supplying the sinews of war to the arsenals of democracy, the mills of America's steel makers.